Today we're going to talk about the power of finishing strong. Yes, before you could finish, you have to start. So any race that you are trying to finish or anything that you're trying to accomplish, you have to first start doing that. So today, as we speak about the power of finishing strong, we have to talk about the keys of starting. In order to start, you have to have a firm foundation. When you build a building and you're building the building, the foundation has to be built properly. And as that foundation is built properly, then you're able to build that building. And that's the beauty about it. As we look at all what's going on around us, we look at the issues with the pandemic, you look at the issues with the economy, you look at the issues in relationship, you look at the issues in society, you look at all of those. And what you could have a tendency of doing is that as you go through those, you stand still and do not learn and do not grow. And as you do not learn and you do not grow, then you're not preparing yourself to finish strong. You see, growth is the process in which you prepare yourself in order to finish strong. If you're going to be a Usain Bolt, you will have to condition yourself. You will have to practice. You will have to run hours every single day in order to prepare yourself to finish strong in an Olympic race. If you're gonna be a motivational speaker or someone who's standing on stage and speaking for hours and speaking to an audience of thousands and thousands of people, you have to prepare, you have to read, you have to hone your craft in order to finish strong. You see, there's a lot of great things that we see happening around us. But one of the key things that we really need today, and you cannot finish strong with, is you cannot finish strong without wisdom. A bunch of my friends and close friends and students are reading through the book of Proverbs, and family members as well. We're reading through the book of Proverbs, and we're going to go through the book of Proverbs every month. And it's basically what we do is that we read a chapter every month and journal about it. And then the months that have 30 days, we read two chapters at the end on that last day, because Proverbs has 31 chapters. Proverbs is known as the book of wisdom. And we've been doing that, and we're going to be doing that every month for a whole year and keep repeating the cycle over and over again. The reason why we picked the book of Proverbs, because just as I said, it's the book of wisdom. Wisdom is one of the key things that you need in order to finish strong. You see, with wisdom comes guidance. With wisdom comes knowledge. With wisdom comes understanding. With wisdom comes grace. With wisdom comes love. With wisdom comes innovation and creativity. With wisdom comes solutions, complex solutions. With wisdom comes crafty ways or unique ways to deal with situations. With wisdom comes grace. With wisdom comes faith. With wisdom comes love. With wisdom comes forgiveness. With wisdom comes long-suffering. With wisdom comes kindness and peace. That and hope comes with wisdom. So you see, that's a unique thing of having wisdom. We always hear that concept, loose lips sink ships. Yes, loose lips sink ships. You see, and that's the beauty about wisdom. So you see, you want to surround yourself with people who are wise. Surround yourself with people, not just people who just speak as they want to speak, but people who think before they speak. People who don't just speak their minds. You can't just speak your minds in tough situations. The words that you speak has to be wholesome. The words that you speak have to bring life. The words that you speak have to be full of wisdom. And when you're adhering to wisdom, you cannot be a loose-lipped person, because loose lips sink ships. So in order to finish strong, you have to surround yourself with people who function in the realm of wisdom. So whenever they speak into your life, they speak words of wisdom. They speak words of grace. They give you advice that is wise. They give you advice that will grow you. They give you advice that will propel you forward. They give you advice that will spread forth love, that will spread forth grace that will spread forth the love and the anointing of your Creator. That's the type of people you want to surround. So as you're finishing or as you're growing, you want to always make sure that you have good advisors around you. And also, whenever you're doing things, make sure you seek counsel. But make sure the people who you're seeking counsel from also read the good book. Not only just read it, but walk it out, act it out, move and function in wisdom. Because you don't want people speaking into your life with hate and malice and hostility. You want people who are able to speak wisdom within you, or wisdom to you. And that wisdom comes from a relationship with your Creator. And if you're taking a bath in the Holy Book, if you're taking a bath in the Word, and if you are allowing the Word to wash you, it will transform your character and it will transform you from the inside out. So that's the beauty of wisdom. Another thing that you want to do is that you want to always be going and moving in grace. You want to always be going and moving in grace. You want to move forward in grace. When people are telling you that you need to lash out, you have to remember, you know, that you have a word spoken in wisdom will bring forth life. A word spoken in wisdom will bring forth peace. A word spoken in wisdom will bring forth grace and love and unity. Unity. Bring things together instead of pulling things apart. You see? We all want to finish strong. We all want to go through and do all the stuff that we want to do in life. But the key fundamental fact is we have to always adhere to wisdom. And as we adhere to wisdom, you see, wisdom is so unique because wisdom brings love. Wisdom brings grace in its hand. Wisdom causes the aging process, causes your life to be extended. And wisdom causes you to look alive, because what happens is that it's flowing from the inside out. And as that love and as that grace flows out of you, that's when you bring about a strong finish. You know, I've taken the last couple of months and I've sat down and I've read and I've studied the good book. I've read and prayed and did all the different things that I do every day. And the key fundamental things, a lot of people may not understand it and a lot of people may not see it, because a lot of people are reactionaries. They just react to circumstances. But there's a wave coming. There's a huge wave coming. And as that wave comes, you have to be prepared for that waves. You see, when you go to the beach, I remember one time going to the beach and it was just after a storm and there was some huge waves. And I tried to go out into the water. And when I tried to go out in the water, this huge wave came and doubled me up and just simply slashed me on the shore. I'm telling you, I was eating sand because I wasn't prepared for it. You see, and that's what happened in life. If you're not prepared, if you're complacent, you cannot finish strong. And a lot of people, what they do, they're very wishy-washy in their ways. They're very wishy-washy in their thinking, because what they do, they neglect their preparation. And because they neglect their preparation, whenever the storms of life or whenever the tough times come or whenever tough situations come, they cannot finish strong. Their trees don't have any roots going down. And when the bellows and the winds of life and the storms of life blow against them, they topple over. Their buildings are built improperly. Their foundations are not adequately fortified. Their foundations are not adequately built. And because their foundations are not adequately built, that building, whenever the ground starts shaking, it just topples over. And that's the thing with wisdom. You want to sit down. You want to take the time and you want to prepare. You want to sit down and you want to take the time to gain wisdom, gain understanding. Because the fact is, when things get tough, that's when you need to pour out even more wisdom. When things get tough, that's when people will seek out the ones who speak forth with wisdom. When things get tough, that's when people seek out the ones who speak forth wise advice. You see, you have have to be able to speak into your families. You have to be able to speak into your businesses. You have to be able to speak into your communities. You cannot be a loose lip and sink ships. You have to be someone who speaks forth with wisdom. So I want to encourage you to go out there today and learn to discipline yourself to build that foundation. Build that foundation nestled upon wisdom. And I want to encourage you, hey, you could start reading the book of Proverbs with us. You know, you could start right now and catch up, or you could start at the beginning of the month, you know, that the next month. And as you're starting, I want you in any mediums that you see this video, in the comment section below, just simply write, I'm in. Type I'm in and put it in the comments, and I'll be praying for you. Go out there today and have an awesome growth day. And don't forget, hit the subscribe button below. And when you hit the subscribe button, don't forget to select the bell, because by selecting the bell, it will notify you whenever I add a future video. Thank you very much. God bless you.